Welcome to a new video. It's been a while. It's been a very, very big while, actually. It's 2 weeks, if I am not mistaken. And it's been a while because I've been trying to get better at this sort of videos and trying to make videos which are quite instructive. And I attempted a few times to make a video, but I lost hopelessly in the position where I was talking. So that was the reason why. Simply because I thought that wasn't good enough for some reason. But now, let's just upload whatever the outcome of this game is, and however bad I play, we analyze after the game. We are focused here on not having any opening theory, or at least a very small opening theory. We just base everything on opening principles, like putting the knight out, develop knights before bishops. There might be some opening theory involved, like, but not much. And we'll basically figure everything out on our own as quickly as possible. So he plays e5. And this is might be a bit annoying because of e4. But I feel like if we play knight f3 e4, we can play bishop g5. And then we can snatch after pawn. Maybe we can play e4. But this would create weaknesses. So I don't judge that situation to be... Actually, it's very bad. Because... But he doesn't play it. After, if he played e4 here, so you can already see I'm already kind of struggling here. We could not even go with bishop g5 because he just simply takes. So that was a slight mistake on our part, but our opponent doesn't see it. So that was nice.
That was nice.
And this is exactly what I'm talking about. My play has been quite lackluster. And let's play d3 to then avoid e4 now. Play like a chicken, and now if he does play this, we could go there, but now he avoids it, so he still wants to play e5, I assume. Because this is the plan of their opponent, I feel very inclined to play e4 ourselves, just avoiding any plans, taking some space, taking control of some squares, and he has been playing a lot with his pawns, but it doesn't seem like this has been a very huge influence. We could put a knight here, but then he would just quickly strike back. So I think it's just most wise to develop the bishops. Either one are fine. I decided to for this one. And knight there. Okay. So yeah. What this basically tells me is that he wants to reserve a possibility for playing f5 at a given moment. There we think, then we think, because the prospect of having an f5 is just very annoying. But what I'm also seeing is that the king is a bit awkward in the place where it is right now. But how to create game from this? How do we create anything from this position? The position is quite closed, we cannot do much, and I'm trying to figure this out. So, because there is not much to do, I think it's just simplest to castle here, play bishop e2 and maybe castle. Though there is an idea of playing b4, and if takes, we open up the position a little bit and we can retake the pawn via the check. Alright, so there is a possible, there are no possible checks for Black at the moment. He has developed the bishop, so in case we have to retake with this pawn on here, he can take this one maybe, potentially, if the bishop were not to be here. That's what I'm seeing. And I still feel like b4 does make sense. But let's be very, very normal here, and we just simply castle. There's nothing going on in this position. And we have developed five pieces whilst our opponent has developed two. So we're definitely doing great. We're not worse. Here I do feel like a knight here would make sense because the knight has now moved here, he cannot retake. If he takes the bishop, we get a bishop pair and a good pawn here, avoiding not having giving him any space. And still here we do have the earlier b4. So he takes. So what pawn should we retake with? That's a really good question. I think it's best to take with the c-pawn, because if you do it with the e-pawn, there might be some possibilities of e5 being nasty together with f5, e5, e4. So I opted for this one, and now he has a backwards pawn. This could be very weakening. Like, you could already imagine, like, taking here and then taking here if the knight were not to be here. So yeah. So what to do now? We've developed every pieces. The only thing we need to do is connect the rooks. I think we're gonna do that via queen b3. The rooks are now connected and we are attacking, so he has to respond to that, and I think that's very simple chess, nothing too difficult, and he responds by playing b4. Okay, and anytime I see this pawn structure, I'm very inclined to play a4. I should at least consider it, and I don't see why I should not play it in this situation. This would ruin black's pawn structure a lot. Okay, our pawn on b2 might be weak. I have might not have thought about it too greatly here, but yeah, you can already see things are not going as black wants it to go. So yeah, so I see this outpost now, because he has pushed his pawn. I see this outpost on c4, so I'm thinking, let's put a knight here and then put it here, and then we also have this option of playing f4 whenever we please also. So let's finish that idea. And this, okay, we might have like double pawns, but this is actually really strong in my opinion, and this is always a target, a backwards pawn, the base of the pawn chain actually in this case. So what to do now? So we have developed fully, he has not. Yes, he has to develop, and I think it's actually plausible to break open the position here, and after takes, takes, maybe take again, we have an open file for the rook, and things look good. But we might want to prepare that move, because after we play f4, we open up this diagonal. It doesn't look scary at the moment. Maybe it's not needed, but for good sakes principled, I think I'm gonna play king h1 first and then play f4. And you might think to yourself, when have you become a very solid, boring chess player? And the answer to that is yes. So yeah. But as you can see, our position is just good. And yes, I have maybe become very boring, but it's also just the way some things go. So I see an x-ray here. It's a very, very far-sighted x-ray, but we could use it at some point. Not now, but at some point. So let's play f4 as well as we want to play, and if he doesn't take, we might play f5, gaining even more space, thinking about maybe sex, rerouting the queen, boom 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 boom, and everything goes there, bam bam bang bang bang, exactly. And but he takes, so what should we trade with? I think we have to retake with the bishop, and in hindsight this might not have been the best, because he can just drop it there, and he also has open lines now, so it's actually not clear if what I did was actually correct, but we will see after the game if anything. There's also a possibility of putting the knight back on e3 and then rerouting it to f5. The queen definitely is not doing a great job on b3. We should it's actually quite misplaced. We should probably reroute it to somewhere else, maybe here, maybe put the rook here first and then here. I'm not sure. Alright, so this is now protected by two pieces. I'm still in favor of the knight jump. Okay, we're not putting the rook in the game, but he might have some possibilities of some tactics here, and he wants to probably put the bishop here, stopping any advancements, but then we are gonna put our knight there. And I think my knight here is a bit better placed than here. Puts the bishop there. Okay, interesting. So if I go here now, You can just take, and if I take here, you can take. And I'm not sure, like, if that's good for me or not. Like, it doesn't seem to be that great. So I'm gonna put my knight here as planned. So if he push here, we are both threatening the bishop and the rook without any compensation. All right, he plays this. So I don't see a reason for us not to play this now. Going for the rook, but also going for the bishop. And yes, he gains an outpost, but we gain a rook. So that should be quite good. And in this raiding rage until 1500, these types of tricks actually quite work a lot of the times. You could say it's a trick, but it's also what we did was also positionally sound in a way, as far as I understand. And this is also often what happens. Rook a6 is just, I think I already said something here where the bishop has an x-ray. We should really, like, this was actually already essentially a sort of inaccuracy, which we try to, which we try to take care of. Okay, it might not be the most best way, well, but in the end we got it. And now we win this. Okay, he retakes with the knight. This will be a bit unpleasant to work towards, but here already we can threaten some type of checks. Let's do that, as I see not why not. Let's see, the knight here could be unpleasant, but the bishop is defending everything. But we also have to check is the back move of the knight. So if he plays it here, he can just put the knight back there, which is actually, which might still be quite pleasant. But we can also put the knight rook here. If you put the rook here and it goes back, we can also go here with the intention of taking and then still creating the threat. And I like that idea. Let's double check if there's nothing in it. I don't think so. Let's go here. There might be c4, no. Also fine. And black's counterplay is essentially here in the pawns now. Because he is up a pawn, you have to be careful here to not let these pawns overextend, because when they start running, they really go fast. Okay, so he places there. I don't see n no reason to not go for this check. You can also consider knight taking, but then rook g1, I don't like that. So let's take, and then bring the queen over. Because when pieces leave space, places, it can be occupied by other places. All right. And now we bring the queen over here. I think that's even more accurate. I think only move is queen b6 though, which is a bit annoying. Because after rook takes, queen takes, we are actually, yeah. So that's not good. But I do think rook here is a solid move. Let's play that. And we might just do something random like this. I don't know. We might go here. I have yet to find a tactic here, but I think this is just a solid positional move here. It's defended by the bishop. The bishop cannot be attacked by any piece. We're maintaining the tension here a little bit. We might need to drop the rook back. And there might even be a possibility of shifting the rook over here. Okay, he takes a rook due to all the pressure he has been in. And now we have to be clinical here. And I do sometimes struggle in these types of situations where I'm forced to find something really good in a very small amount of time. Check here. And maybe something like this. Let's just be safe, give a check, make the king a bit less active. And he plays this. Okay. Well, let's just bring the bishop in. And maybe there are some plans of going here and here. If your opponent out of the way, you place this. Okay, let's just play h3. Everything looks fine, everything looks good. Now there are no backmarked mates. You don't have to fight. Yeah, it's just very positional what I'm doing at the moment. At any point we could play queen g4, attacking here, but maybe also threatening something like this. Going to f5, and then eventually make our way to somewhere. Even taking, and then takes on f8 to stand on the board. So let's try to do that. And I just realized that this pawn was hanging for a long time, which I did not spot. Because there, we'll go here, going for mate. Not mate, but going for this tactic, like takes, takes, and then takes, which should eventually end the game in good fashion. He goes there, which is a good move. Let's give this check first. Getting out of the attack of the rook. And when he goes here, we just take, and after take, we take here. I don't see the mate. We can also just take here, I guess. But let's keep things simple. We're threatening also to check here. We are also up on time now. Our opponent is very sweet for taking their time. And now we just simply take. And there was probably mate somewhere. But I think that's a solid game. Maybe after, well, if he goes here, I think I just simply take the rook, honestly. Even if I don't see the mate in 4, I see the mate in a later stage. And if he took, you just simply take, and we don't even have to find a mate, we can just simply promote. Okay, we could give the mate as well, I guess. If I saw it, but I don't. Maybe something like this. There are loads of mates to find. But let's analyze position. So what I'm wondering is, after e4, which you always should consider the pawn pushes for yourself and for your opponent, what the best move here is. And the engine gives a simple knight takes on e4, and I feel really stupid for not seeing it. So knight f3, d6, d3 was not necessary in the end, and e4, and we sort of get a structure which is very common. I don't know what name of the structure is, but a lot of people play it. We continue the game, and as I previously said, if the bishop takes, we gain the bishop pair and a very strong stronghold on d5. And the opponent might be thinking he has double pawns, but these double pawns are actually, in this case, really strong. So let's continue. As previously mentioned, when I see this, a4 should be considered, and apparently by the engine this is considered top move. And this is apparently an inaccuracy. What is the best name? A5. And this is very much beyond me. It does make sense as we open up the A4 square. So let's say knight D2. D7, sorry. And now the engine takes back his worth. And I have no clue what he's pointing at. Like, what's your point, my friend? And now it suggests knight e2. So I don't think the engine was right here. I think knight e2 is a very fine move. I don't see any like concrete ideas. And then as the game continued, as you can see, rook a6 is an inaccuracy because it does put an indirect pin here. And f4 is apparently also not good, which I kind of sensed after playing it. So yeah, as you can see, I obviously have some holes in my understanding of the game. And here, d4 simply wins a piece. We simply shift over, and this was probably a piece of cake. If he wouldn't play this and plays a random move, like let's say here, trying to create something on this, I think rook g3 was a good move. Just shifting it back, and after that we're gonna take. He does have some counterplay here, but we just simply take in this case as well. And engine even says that there's a mate here, which I don't see. Actually, I would like to see that mate. It starts with knight takes on h6. Oh, because this is unstoppable. Ah, and then you're just gonna go back. So the only defense is to defend this, but then we just take a queen. Just one question on my mind, and this is, why is f4 not good? The pawn. And I think I figured it out. I think I figured it out why f4 immediately was bad. Because this bishop here is actually an asset in position, and you don't want to trade it off. That's the whole reason why this was good. Let's say he didn't trade off the knight for the bishop, and did any other move. Like, let's develop this knight. All of a sudden, I think the engine will prefer our position again. Point four, as you can see. Because this bishop is something you really want to have in the position. That's why I preferred g3 first over f4 immediately. So yeah, okay, I feel proud of figuring that out. Trying to translate the words of the engine into like human language. And yeah, that's the game. Thank you for watching. A pretty long one this time. Hope you like the new format. Hope you like my new mic. Can you see the mic? Yeah. So I'm working on improving the quality. There might be some discrepancies in the quality from time to time because I'm experimenting. Thank you for watching. For the 7 or less people who are watching, and see you next time.